The first, and probably the most common fault, is leaning on the lead arm when you take a breath. You can see here, as I breathe to the right, my arm is completely straight as I'm pushing down on the water rather than catching it. You can also see the timing of the stroke goes completely awry as well, as that lead arm accelerates down through the water. So, not only are you not catching the water properly, but the timing is lopsided and uneven. So one stroke doesn't follow the other, moving you forward through the water. So the drill we'd like to use to correct this very, very common fault is probably the first drill that you ever got taught as a swimmer. Hopefully you've all had a go at this drill one time or another, and it's called basic extension. So why is this an important drill? Well, it's essentially the position you get into with every stroke. You can see Rob here with the hand extended and the rear arm resting on his hip. Pretty much a freeze frame of every stroke that he takes. Now, have a look when Rob takes a breath. You can see that he keeps the head buried in the water. He doesn't lift the head out of the water. He has the water crossing one goggle lens and skimming the corner of his mouth. At the same time as he breathes, you'll see the extended hand stays exactly where it is. If you look at most people when they do this drill for the first time, they're pushing down on the water, aiding the breathing with the lead arm. So the more you do this drill, the more you train the brain that it's rotation rather than assistance that allows you to get a good, clean breath. So the camera will pan up in a moment to the head-on screen at my endless pool, and you'll see that this is pretty much a freeze frame of the front crawl stroke. If Rob was to start swimming here, he'd be repeating this position over and over again. Once again, if you look at the lead hand, you can see how stable it is. So if you do one length on your right, followed by one length on your left, what you're doing is training the brain not to lead down with that arm. And once the stroke has been balanced, then you've got half a chance of engaging the water with a good catch like this, where there is no downward pressure on the water. You're initiating at the elbow, getting over the water and moving past the static hand forearm blade.
British Triathlon, proudly partnered by GE. Imagination at work.